How turtles got their shells. It all started 260 million years ago when land was much smaller and ocean was much larger. There were many forests and deserts, and in the middle of these vast deserts, there would be this tiny creature basking in the sunlight. It looked like a lizard, but it had very wide ribs, which lizards don't have. Scientists were very interested by this creature as soon as they found its fossil. We now know this fossil as the Eunotosaurus. They also said the Eunotosaurus was a digger because its head was shaped like a shovel, its wide ribs could help it dig, and it had big claws, which most diggers have. That was the first stage on how the turtle got its shell, which was the widening of the ribcage. Because of this, the turtles had to find a new way to breathe because the ribcage helped it breathe. Since that happened, its organs are protected from the top and the bottom. Next stage was the odontocalus. The second step was forming the plastron. The odontocalus had plastron and no carapace. The plastron is the undershell and the carapace is the top shell. The plastron came first, which is something that many scientists, including me, thought was interesting. The third stage was the prognathocalus, which meant early shell. Prognathocalus was named the first true turtle because it had both the carapace and the plastron, and was the first found out of the three turtles. There is no complete answer to why turtles got their shells, but I hope you understand how turtles got their shells. Some people say turtles got their shell for protection, but it is not possible considering some turtles, like the soft-shell turtle, which have a soft, squishy shell. Thank you.